I could take it to the room, or I could take it to the beach, but we gotta leave it now.
Astro. Yep. Sun is down, freezing cold. That's how we already know. When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him. Yeah. 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 Gone on you with the pick and roll. Younger Flame, he in sicko mode.
Made this here with all the ice on in the booth. At the gate outside, when they pull up, they give me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys, that's Nike boys hopping our coupes. Way too big, when we pull up, give me the loot.
Give me the loot!
Was off the Remy, had up at post. 2-4-hour lockdown, we made no move.
This is the final battle on Guitar Hero 3. Expert mode, Hyper Speed 5, and I'm not even looking. Let's get it.
Way behind me, he's gonna make a deal. Came across a young boy playing that thing I feel hot. I'm gonna dump on every subject. What are the tiny odds? I bet you didn't know that I'm a fiddle player too. And if you can't, I'll take a dare, I'll make a back at you. I'm gonna be a little boy, I'm gonna get a damn stupid. I'm gonna be a soldier, I think I'm better than you. The boy said, my name's Johnny, and it might be a sin.
Whammy.
Let's go!
Welcome to Slam Poetry. Here we go.
Slam Poetry. Yelling. Angry. Waving my hands a lot. Specific point of view on things. Cynthia. Jesus died for our sin. The us. Jesus cried. Runaway bride. Julia Roberts. Julia. Rob. Hurts. Cynthia. Ooh. Cynthia. You are dead. You're dead. Bop boop beep boop boop bop boop. You're dead.
That's for Cynthia.
What's up, DLHS? It's Ben Highmark, and many of you might not know this about me, but I'm amazing at trick shots.
couldn't pass it. Like me, care for you. I'm a bother.
Something that I will be proud of by the end of my high school career. I guess I'd say if there was one thing I'm proud of, it's probably never having owned an Android phone. That one pretty much speaks for itself.
The thing I'm most proud of is my junior and senior year of cross country, I was awarded the Laker Award. The Laker Award goes to the runner that the team feels best showed what a Laker should be during the year. Staying committed, showing up on time, working hard every day, those types of attributes. The point of my senior career that I feel like I most earned that award was during the cross country team's fundraiser, Make the Lake. You have the ability to run 10 miles to make the lake, all the way around the lake. This year, there was a seventh grader on the team that wasn't so sure if he was able to run all 10 miles. And when I was a seventh grader, I can remember a few of my friends and a few of the older kids, we all ran together to be a team. And I told this seventh grader, if you run the 10 miles, I'll run every step of the way with you. I will be there the entire time. And we did it. It took a while, but he ran all 10 miles, and at the end, he was just so happy, and I felt really proud of myself that I was able to help a younger runner be the best runner that he was able to be.
What am I most proud of when it comes to my high school career?
Well, I would have to say I'm most proud that I pretty much did everything I could. I mean, freshman year, didn't do a whole lot, but, you know, I did some baseball and basketball, and then I ended up doing football and track later on, had a good time there. I did musical, you know, I was in pretty much in every club that I could be in, including NHS Student Council, and I went to pretty much all the events I could too. And I don't say this to be like, you know, have it be a flex or anything, but I just thought it was cool that I did pretty much everything I could. And I think more people should do that.
Now that high school is coming to a close, I'd say one thing that I'm most proud of my high school career would probably be the friendships I've made. The friendships I've kept and stuff, like, I would say the friends that I have are probably some of the best people in the world, and I'm really glad to have gotten to meet them and be a part of their lives and to make memories with them before going off to college or going off into whatever futures may hold for them and myself.
So I think I'm really just going to be proud of the amount of friends that I made, you know, more than anything. I think high school is about making good relationships with people, and I really think I achieved that, especially this year. And so I'm really just proud of that, and proud of the relationships with the different teachers that I made. It's been really good.
Their other question was, what do you do to impress your girl's parents on the first date? Let's see, for me, what I try and do is single out the father, and I like to throw him an old 1-2 followed by a left hook. And this works for me most of the time to assert dominance and gain respect from the rest of the family. Or I get kicked out of the house, but either way the decision is made for me. So, I mean, I consider it a win-win, really. Anyways, you can thank me later for that. Feel free to use that one.
Parents, you need to have a firm handshake, good eye contact, and a warm smile. The firm handshake shows that you are respectful of them and that you care about meeting them, and the eye contact shows confidence, and it shows that you're engaged, you're not worrying about anything else, and the warm smile shows that you're genuinely happy to meet them. So if you're respectful, if you're confident in yourself, if you're showing that you care and that you're happy to be there, there's not a better first impression that you can make. So handshake, eye contact, and a smile. Thank you.
So you're about to meet the parents for the first time, and there are some things that you should do that I do to impress them every time. First of all, you need to wear a good outfit. See, I'm wearing my visor, my suit jacket, my vintage Laker track t-shirt, and my Gucci sweatpants. Second, you want to smell really nice. If you have Axe, that is obviously amazing, but if not, just use Old Spice. Third of all, you're gonna need chapstick. See, a man who has chapstick applied and ready means that he is a ready man. Now, when you first get there, you're gonna wanna shake hands. You want it to be a really firm handshake. You just wanna keep going. You know, even if it's awkward, you have to show that you're committed, because you're committed to their daughter. Second of all, compliment them. You can say to the dad, you know, that shirt looks like it's a little tight. Have you been working out recently? And you have a good chuckle. Ha ha. And you turn to the wife and say, oh, are you her sister? You're her mom? Wow. That's amazing. And everyone has a good time over that. Third of all, be realistic. You know, I know you want your daughter to be home at 9:30, but I'm bringing her home at 7. And I don't even hug her, because that would be disrespectful to you guys. Now, fourth of all, and some of you might not be able to do this, so I understand, but don't be afraid to show off how much of a cultured man you are. You might be walking away, it's like, oh, you did notice the Game Boy that I have in my pocket. That's right. I do like to play it. I am cultured like that. Nice meeting you, sir and madam.
Dave's parents, you're going to want to make sure that you're dressed up a little bit, you know, business casual probably. And then you're also going to want to just be as polite as possible. You know, have a smile on your face. Show them you're a good dude. Yeah.
Hello there, Mr. Upton. Hi, it's very nice to meet you. I'm Ben Highmark, and I would just like to start off by saying thank you so much for allowing me to come into your home tonight and to get to know you and your wife a little bit better. Your daughter, Kate, is lovely, and I just cannot wait to get to know the people that raised her.
You're going to want to make sure that if you're driving your date to dinner or wherever you are going, that your car looks nice and clean so that if her parents do happen to check out your car, they see that you are a well-kept man, you know? You're going to want to make sure that your back seat is all cleaned out, all right? Just because if it looks like you're throwing stuff in the back, that's not a good thing. You know, you're just going to want to make sure that you're a well-kept person and you got all your ducks in a row.
So if I'm going on a date and, you know, I'm trying to meet the parents, you know, I really just gotta wear a tie. You gotta go with the tie. And no clip-on. Like, you know, you gotta tie the tie. Find out how to do that. I know how to do that, actually. You gotta do that. You gotta make sure that when you meet them, you nice, firm handshake. Firm handshake. You can't be weak. They don't want no weak man dating their daughter. Trust me. Or son. So if I do that, I meet their parents, make sure don't bring up politics, don't bring up touchy subjects, you know, you don't want to do that. You want to, you know, keep things clean, you know, use table manners, but be honest, you know, be yourself. Don't fake it. Cause if their parents, you know, if they're not cool people or if they don't like you, then you got to get that out. Got to get that out of the way, you know, right away. So, you know, I would just, you know, make sure manners, firm handshake, wear a tie, stay away from touchy subjects, just be yourself, you know?